Apple has just announced how they're going to switch over to their own ARM chips at WWDC 2020, as well as when we should expect new hardware and how the apps are going to get switched over. So let's get right into it and answer a lot of questions. But before we get into how that transition will work, let's discuss the newly redesigned macOS software that will run on those ARM Macs. macOS Big Sur is basically becoming a lot more like iPadOS software, with the same dock, the same control center features with similar controls, and much more. All of Apple's apps like Photos, Messages, and Calendar now look and feel like iPad apps because they were made using Apple's Catalyst feature, which is meant to port iOS apps over to macOS. So basically, iOS is now merging with macOS, and we know this because every ARM Mac is going to be able to run any iOS app or iPadOS app, which you can download straight from the Mac App Store. And as for games, ARM Macs are going to get controller support as well, so we'll be able to play games like Fortnite and Call of Duty Mobile natively on the new ARM Macs. In fact, Apple's entire macOS presentation was run on a Mac using Apple's A12Z processor, which is the same one that comes in the 2020 iPad Pro. But they also mentioned that they'll have a new family of scalable Apple chips, so they won't come with the same chips as iPhones or iPads. Now the big question is how third-party apps or professional apps are going to run on these new ARM Macs. Well, Apple has already mentioned that Final Cut Pro and Logic Pro are already running on these chips, and they've been working with Adobe and Microsoft so that apps like Lightroom, Photoshop, and Microsoft Office are also running natively on the new chips as of right now. And they mentioned that apps like PowerPoint will be using metal acceleration, so they'll perform great on the new chips while using less power. Now, as for the third-party apps, Apple has created a new Universal 2 binary language that allows apps to run on both Intel chips and Apple's custom chips at the same time. And Apple has a new version of Xcode that will allow developers to recompile their apps using this new language instantly. And they're so confident in this that they said that most developers can get their apps switched over and working in just days. So they should be ready for the first ARM Macs, which Apple has confirmed to be later this year. Now, as for the apps that don't get updated in time, Apple has created Rosetta 2. This is basically a new version of emulation software which automatically translates existing apps to work on the new chips. This means that every single app we have right now on macOS should work on an ARM Mac, even if the developer doesn't touch it at all. And this will all work in the background with no additional steps required by you. They even said that Rosetta 2 will translate code and plugins on the fly. Now the question is, how fast are these apps going to be emulated? Well, Apple is promising high performance, and they even showed off Maya running on ARM, and it looked very smooth. They also showed off the popular x86 Tomb Raider game running smoothly as well. And to help developers with the Switch, Apple has launched a new forum, and they're even going to send developers a Mac Mini with the same A12Z chip from the iPad Pro to help developers test and get their apps ready to go. Now here's the big question, can you run Windows on the new ARM Macs? Well, Apple showed off Parallels running Linux, and they mentioned the new virtualization software tools that can help run different software. And seeing as Microsoft is already working with Apple to get their apps running on these new Macs, there's a good chance that they'll be working together to get Windows running as well. But it might be confined to using Parallels or something else instead of booting directly into Windows. Now, the most important question that Apple has answered was if they will ditch Intel and move over to their own chips completely, and the answer is no. Apple said that ARM Macs are coming later this year, but they also mentioned that they're going to be creating Macs with Intel chips for years to come. But at the same time, they also mentioned a 2-year transition period, so let me give you my own personal opinion on all of this. that 2-year transition basically means that for the next 2 years, Apple is not going to enforce apps to be updated to support both Intel and Apple chips. But once the 2 years is over, the apps that haven't been updated will disappear off of the App Store. And as far as the Intel situation, I think that the higher-end Macs will ship with Intel chips. Like for example, the 27-inch iMac, the iMac Pro, the Mac Pro, the 16-inch MacBook Pro, and maybe even an Intel-based Mac Mini. While the lower-end products like the MacBook Air, the 13-inch MacBook Pro, the smaller iMac, and a lower-end Mac Mini will be switched over to ARM chips very soon. In fact, the reliable leaker Ming-Hsu Kuo expects Apple to release an iMac and a 13-inch MacBook Pro running Apple's ARM chips later this year. So if you're in the market for either of those, you should probably wait because those Macs are going to be able to run iOS and iPad apps. So hopefully you learned something new from this video, and if you did, go ahead and tap the like button and click the circle above to subscribe so you don't miss out on more WWDC content coming from us very soon. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.